Hi, in this video we're going to be having a look at what is the internet. It started off with a small group of universities in America that wanted to communicate together, so they laid down some cables between each of their sites. This allowed them to send messages between each of their sites and communicate no matter which computer they were on their individual network. Soon other organisations wanted to join this new network, and very soon the network spread to cover the entire globe. If I wanted to send an email between the UK and Australia, then my email would be split up into separate packets. Each of those packets could travel along different routes to get to its final destination. Once it's at its final destination, then it would be reconfigured back into the original email. Now, the graphics that we've been having a look at are much more simplified versions than what the internet actually looks like. So here we can show you just some of the cables that are laid out underneath the seas, and you can see that they're focused in certain areas. These cables are laid out by huge ships pulling the cables out behind them, so they follow on floating down to the seabed. It can be very difficult to fix these if they become broken in any way. If we have a look just at the UK, then you can see there's some fibre optic cables here. This is from just one provider. There are many providers who also have their own networks. And this doesn't include all of the satellite connections bouncing information between the Earth and the satellites that are surrounding us in space. So as you can imagine, there are billions of connections for this internet. So let's have a look at DNS. DNS stands for Domain Name Server. Now, if you wanted to phone someone using your smartphone, you'll probably have a look in your contacts list. And that's because a lot of phone numbers are very difficult to remember, especially if you don't use them very often. So you'd look up the name of the person that you wanted to contact, and it would then provide the phone number that it would dial for you automatically. That's really how a domain name server works. The IP address, which is the individual unique address for each device connected to the internet, is stored in a large directory. So when we look up a website address, www.bbc.com, then what it actually does is it looks at a domain name server and gets the IP address that it needs to go to. It just means that with these website addresses, we don't need to remember the more complicated IP addresses that are used, and that's how DNS servers work. Okay, so let's have a look at hosting. Large organisations like Amazon or international banks can afford to host their own servers. In fact, Facebook has just purchased its 300,000th server. Smaller organisations can't afford such a luxury, and so they pay a monthly fee to rent space on somebody else's server. Companies like Wix allow you to host a website, and they would even help you register a domain name on the DNS servers. They allow you to publish your website, and they might even provide email services as well. And they keep the whole network secure and keep it running for you, so you don't need to go to the bother of purchasing servers or employing people to run them. So the last thing we're going to have a look at is using the cloud. What this means is that you're saving information on servers over the internet. So when you're saving your images from your iPhone to the cloud, then what you're actually doing is you're storing them on a server somewhere in the world. That means that you don't really have the security of knowing where they're stored, but if it's done through a reputable company, then hopefully they have looked into that and are making sure that they're saved securely for you, particularly if you're storing personal information.